In part one, I built this larger cyclone separator. Now it's time to test it. I just got through running this. If we look inside the bucket, we can see that that tornadic action spins the material inside the bucket. About the most you want to fill one of these is about maybe a little bit over half full. And we're just going to have to play with this larger cyclone and see what effect it has on the collected material. Give you an idea of the difference in size of these two cyclones. This one is about 16 inches tall at this point, and this is 2 foot tall at this point. This is sawdust I got out of the table saw. I've just leveled that by hand. The cyclone's now sitting on top of the bucket. I've got a 2.5 inch hose with 2 inch connections plugged into my ShopVac. My crossover connection for this is not completed yet. I'm just going to hold this on here. We're just going to suck air through here and see how it disturbs the material in the bucket. When this is running, we may have to put a piece of tape on here to keep this from going down. When you interrupt the suction on this, you put a strong vacuum on this cyclone, differential pressure will suck this pipe downwards. I don't want that at the moment. I can see that material has been rotated slightly in the bucket. It's coming up on the sides a little bit. The bottom portion of the cyclone is a little bit dusty, but it hasn't gone up inside of it. And there's no indication of dust on the inside of this pipe. So, that'll probably be okay. The bucket of sawdust I'm using for these tests measures 9 inches down from the top of the bucket. This is primarily sawdust from the table saw. It has a few other things mixed in with it. I'm going to recycle the same pile of sawdust again and again. I'm going to suck it up as fast as I can with whichever vacuum source is being used, which will be either the ShopVac or the dust collection system built into my shop. I'm going to show the process in real time so you get an idea how long it takes for each vacuum source. This is not going to be terribly efficient use of my shop dust collection system. The shop system is really intended to use 4, 5, 6 inch hoses. When you start reducing down to a small size like this, you don't get much airflow through it. The efficiency of this shop system is really dependent on moving a lot of air. So we'll see how it works. It's got quite a bit of fine material in it. the bucket is still 9 inches down. So the more I slow the airflow down through this cyclone, the less efficient it has been in picking up the fine material, which is exactly what I would expect. If you have a ShopVac and you can maintain a large volume of air passing through this, that will keep that material spun up and it'll knock out more of those fines. And if you could put this on top of a small drum, that would get that collected material further away from the bottom of the cyclone. If you're picking up larger shavings off of a portable planer or a joiner, you're probably better off to leave that the 5-inch opening at the bottom. It's less likely to bridge over. I have a 2.5-inch hose with 2-inch connections going to my ShopVac. I have a 2.5-inch hose with 2-inch connections on my pickup side. My bucket of sawdust is 9 inches down. That's picking that material up as fast as I can, which is much, much faster than anything that would be generated in a shop. There's just a little bit of dust on the inside here. And I'm still 9 inches down. I think 10 inches down here is a good setting for this. That's where I'm going to stay. With the 2.5-inch hose connected to my ShopVac, that's the maximum velocity that I can generate in my shop. And this works quite well. A little bit of fines coming back. When I slow this all the way down to the lowest flow, which is connected to my built-in dust collection system in the shop, reduced down to 2-inch, then I get more fine material up here. So as long as you keep your velocity through this thing and keep this spun up, it works pretty well. I'm not losing any material in the collector. I still think this would work better sitting on top of a taller drum. I think you can see that material is being deposited in the bucket quite unevenly. It's being spun up to one side. And that's still about 9 inches down. I have jerry-rigged a connection to my portable planer. Ordinarily, I have a 5-inch connection here reduced to the 3-inch hose going to my shop dust collector. Here I have a 2.5-inch hose with 2-inch connections going to the cyclone, and the same thing going from the cyclone to my ShopVac. And I'm just going to take some cuts off of a 2x4, run it down a little bit, and we'll look inside and see at the shavings that we cut. That reduced a 13.5-inch 2x4 down to 0.5-inch. I take this piece off the top. There's no fine material in there at all. And that's what's left of that 2x4. What happened there was this hose sucked up tight on the bucket, and that differential pressure I was telling you about pulled this hose, this pipe, all the way down inside. And I had this set at 12 inches.